Hi guys, Ben Worsler here, former Fat Kid, formerfatkid.com, bensbootcamps.com. I wanted to shoot you a quick video before I head out to my snowshoe workout today with my two dogs. It's actually freezing today, so we'll see how that workout goes. I believe it's about 4 below right now, and the high is supposed to be 2 above for the day, so it's quite chilly to say the least. But I'll be out there. I love snowshoeing. It's exciting. It's a good way to get outside in the wintertime, despite the cold weather. But that's not the reason why I shot this video today. I wanted to talk about goals. I met with a group yesterday, and it's our first metabolism makeover program, and it's our first week. So we were talking a lot about goals and how important goals should be. Now, I was thinking about that, and I think there's a misconception about goals and how important goals are. I mean, we all know, you hear every day about how setting goals are really going to put you on the path to success, and give you a roadmap, and things of that matter. But I think the important part of a goal is making sure that it's important. For example, I hear a lot, my goal is to get fit and healthier. That's a great goal, but what does that mean? You know, how will you, and I ask a lot of my clients, I ask them, you know, how will you know when you get there? You know, how can you measure that as a success? If you can't measure it, then you're gonna be ongoing for the rest of your life trying to reach that goal, which you don't have a way of measuring it. And I do believe that everybody in their mind has that, what they have in mind of being fit, being healthy, getting in better shape. But, you know, what does that mean? And I think it's something that has to be in the forefront of your mind. We write our goals down on paper, but we also keep them in our heads. I like to have them say the same thing. So if someone were to read that, they'd say, okay, I know exactly what you want. And the person knows exactly what they want, obviously, as well. But, let me give you an example. Going back to that getting fit, getting healthy idea, maybe it's reaching a performance level. For example, being able to run up 3 flights of stairs without feeling like you're going to keel over and die. You know, that's a good goal to have. As far as being healthy, maybe it has something to do with your cholesterol level, your blood pressure. You know, those are specific numbers. You can also go with a performance base. Not everybody has to go for a scale weight. Some people like to go clothing size or circumference measurements. I want to fit into my skinny jeans again. You know, something that's very descriptive, that's very important to you, is going to drive you further, and it's going to push you harder than before because it's important to you. You know, getting fit, getting healthy, that's a good goal. That's not a driving force behind the action steps that you're going to take that are actually going to get you to your goal. It's got to be descriptive. It's got to be personal, and it's almost got to be to the point where it's emotional. So when you read it, you really are compelled to take those steps to reach the goals that you want to achieve. And that is when you have that down, and when you have that set, and you have that in the forefront of your mind, that's when you really start to catapult your success. You really start taking the action steps like planning ahead, eating supportively, avoiding those foods that aren't going to help you, exercising on a regular basis, because you are compelled due to your passion to succeed. Getting fit and healthy is not a passion. It's more of a wish. So find your passion. Find the reason you really want to succeed. And why you are spending all this time preparing healthy food and exercising. And put that in the forefront of your mind, and you will succeed. You won't be frustrated anymore. Okay? It may sound a little simple. It may sound a little easy, but it's not. I mean, you really have to dig deep. And what you may have thought was a goal initially, maybe no longer is a goal now. Because it doesn't mean as much to you as you really thought. All right. So I suggest writing those goals down, making them as descriptive as possible, maybe even write them as an affirmation, as if they've already happened. For example, real quick example is I'm so glad that I have lost the 20 pounds that I have worked so hard all my life to achieve. I am now able to run around with my kids. My blood pressure is now within a healthy range, and I can go up a flight of stairs and still feel fit and strong. You know, something like that, that's very important to you, that you can read every day. Okay, so that's my quick tip on goals. Write them down. Don't skip this step. Watch your success. You know, watch your success grow because of the details that you implement. All right. Quick note, just to finish up. This week is the week before the Dave Whitley Kettlebell Workshop. If you're in the Northeast Kingdom of Vermont, if you're near this area, we're going to be having a workshop on Saturday, January 24th at Linden State College. If you want to get in on that, you have to email me as soon as possible. We're not going to be taking spots the day of the event. It's going to be too crazy. So we've got about 15 people now. We can take 30, but I think we're going to cap it off at about 20. It's a good working number to work with. So if you want to get in on that, email me. Just respond to this email respond to the my email right below the screen here. And I'll get you signed up and get you all the details, and we can get you registered. It's definitely an event you don't want to miss if you're in the Northeast Kingdom area. A professional like this doesn't come around our neck of woods very often. So get in on that if you're interested at all in kettlebell training. All right. This is Ben Worsler, former fat kid. Ben, bensbootcamps.com. Have a great day, guys.